I'll take leaders' questions under standing orders 27, and I call Deputy Micheál Martin.
I just might give a second, please, for the host to clear a Kiln Corlett, or less Kiln Corlett. Just might give a second for the host to clear. Taoiseach, I want to raise this morning a situation that is essentially a matter of life and death for a number of people in this country. In particular, I've been approached by John Duggan from Meath and people representing Mary Gorman from Ballinakil, both who have been denied Soliris, a drug therapy which can have a dramatic impact on patients with a very rare blood disorder. It's a condition that affects quite a small number of people globally, PNH. It's a rare acquired blood disorder, which is life-threatening, severely life-threatening. 35% of patients will die within 5 years of diagnosis. 70% of patients will end up with end-stage renal failure. So this is a very serious issue for the people concerned. The clinicians involved, in particular Dr. Philip Murphy, consultant haematologist in Beaumont, for example, has written to John Duggan. He has consulted with Professor Peter Hillman, the leading UK expert, and indeed with Professor Paul Brown, both who say that this drug is essential for such patients, and both agree that John should be in treatment with this drug therapy, Soliris. And Taoiseach, in 2010, it was decided that 10 patients with this condition would get the drug. And 10 patients since 2010 are in treatment under the drug therapy. But over the last 2 years, new patients coming onto the scene are being denied the drug by the authorities. And as Dr. Philip Murphy said in his letter to John, there is a very strong moral, ethical argument that the HSE should agree to fund the Soliris therapy. Mary Gorman, Taoiseach, had to go on the Sean O'Rourke programme to highlight her case, because she's been left for 2 years with no treatment to control her disease, even though medical experts want her to be treated appropriately. She's had to give up her job. She's been subject to firefighting interventions such as frequent blood transfusions. She's now severely restricted. And Taoiseach, NICE, the National Institute for Health and Care Excellence in the United Kingdom, have issued guidance in relation to this drug, saying that its impact is a step change in terms of the treatment of this condition, and that it offers people the possibility of avoiding end-stage renal failure, dialysis and kidney transplantation, as well as other organ damages. And that the analysis from all sides are indicating that the substantial quality of life differences and gains made are of a magnitude that is rarely seen for any new drug treatment.
Thank
now,
you,
Taoiseach, by any yardstick, I think it's unacceptable that these individuals have been left without access to this drug. And it is a very expensive drug, that I acknowledge. But it's not your role and the government's role to be playing God with people's lives. And I say that sincerely, because if these cases weren't raised in the public domain, I don't think we would be having this debate right now. And basically, I'm putting it to you, Taoiseach, that the defence of the minister last evening, that it's a matter for others and not the minister, is not acceptable. 10 people are already on this drug. The authorities have approved it for 10 people. But a decision has been made. A decision has been made not to give it to Mary Gorman and to John Duggan. And I'd like to know why, Taoiseach. And how can we in this society say some citizens are more equal than others? Now, the minister last night said that the million euros involved could do a lot of other things. Well, the bottom line, it can do a lot of other things. But in this instance, it can save 2 lives, Taoiseach, and dramatically transform their quality of life. And I'm asking you, Taoiseach, to cut through the bureaucracy and get this issue sorted and facilitate access to this life-saving drug therapy to the people concerned who need it and whose clinicians are saying that it's essential that they get it.
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Thank Deputy Martin for raising this sensitive and personal matter. I have no intention of attempting to play God, as you say. It's neither my function nor within my authority, obviously. I can understand the situation here for the people that you mention. Now, you said that a decision has been made not to provide treatment by this drug for the people involved here. The decision was made to have a pilot scheme of 10 people, and 10 people were nominated, I assume, through medical or clinical channels for that. I understand that the cost here is in excess of 200,000 per person, obviously a very expensive drug. It's not the first expensive drug. In proportion, we've had similar ones for cystic fibrosis, and there's the cure now for hepatitis C, which are also expensive drugs in proportion, with a huge backlog in many of those cases. This matter was raised yesterday by Deputy Helen McEntee here in the House as a topical issue, and was responded to by the Minister for Health. My understanding is that the company involved have been were here for a couple of days, have had discussions with the Health Service Executive, and obviously I'm not privy to the outcome of those discussions, but the opportunity exists, I suppose, to see what can be done in the case of the two people that you mentioned, or others who are in the same category. You'll be aware that it's never the intention of the Minister of the Department of the HSE to attempt to deliberately rule anybody out of having treatment that can, you know, affect their lives for the better, or that in some cases is, you know, virtually a matter of being able to have a longer life than might be expected. As I understand it, those discussions haven't finally concluded, and I suppose that, in fairness, they do want to see the outcome of the pilot scheme that is currently underway at the with the drug involved at the cost that's here. So it's a matter that the Minister is well aware of, that he responded to Deputy McEntee and for the information of the House yesterday on this, and obviously I'd like to think that, arising from that topical issue having been raised, that the discussions that were underway with the HSE and the drugs company involved might be able to go a little further. I'd like to think that the people that you mentioned and others who are caught in this particular problem, we'd like to think that they could be facilitated here. Unfortunately, there are so many other areas of, in a person's life, equal priority for access to drugs of proportionate cost or whatever, who look for the same facility. And I have no intention, Deputy Martin, of attempting to say you can and you cannot have access to this. There is only a certain allocation that you can make here, and there was the introduction of a pilot program for 10 people to see the impact and the effect of the drug treatment on the quality and the quality of lives of the people involved.
Thank you.
So I'll obviously bring the fact that you've raised it here to the Minister's attention, as it was brought to his attention by Deputy McEntee yesterday evening.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy Micheál Martin.
Did you get answer simply? Is not good enough? Yes. You're the boss. And in 2010, Taoiseach, in 2010, deputies on the Fine Gael side of the House, quite rightly, raised it in the Dáil, the issue of this drug therapy, with the then Minister, Antonis de Mary Harney. And in accordance with the letter from Dr. Philip Murphy, he says initially the HSE agreed to fund 10 patients with PNH, but despite attempts by myself to get this funding agreed over the past 2 to 3 years, I recently have had correspondence from Sean Flanagan, chief pharmacist of the HSE, that he is not in a position to fund a colizumab therapy for any more PNH patients at present. So it's a funding issue, Taoiseach.
Simple as that.
It is not, as the Minister tried to indicate last night, to do with the efficacy of the drug. Because there's no issue with the efficacy of the drug in terms of the world leading clinicians in this area. And it's time, Taoiseach, the position has hardened in the last 2 to 3 years on health and on the issue of new innovative drug therapies. That's what's happening, Taoiseach. And the consequence of that is that two citizens that I know of, and there may be a third or fourth, are being denied drug therapy that 10 other citizens have been availing of for the last 3 years. On any basis of equality, that is not acceptable. It is not acceptable. And it is a life and death issue. And there will be extra costs on the HSE when renal failure begins to take place, or thrombosis, or the other side effects of this particular condition, or the very regular blood transfusions that will even get more frequent as the condition deteriorates. And meanwhile, the people, in one case, one person already has had to leave her job because of the failure to enable her to avail of this particular therapy.
Thank you, Deputy.
This is a funding issue, Taoiseach. And as I mentioned about NICE in the UK, who are not known, by the way, to be flahuluk with approving new drug therapies, they're clear that this drug therapy is a step change in treatment for this rare condition and disorder. And it's about time now, Taoiseach, that the Minister took responsibility and stopped hiding behind other authorities and the HSE and others when there's a matter of life and death involved.
Thank you.
And it's urgent, Taoiseach, because the longer it goes on, the risks are higher in terms of something very serious happening to the people concerned.
Sorry, I have to call the
Taoiseach. That's the issue, Taoiseach. And that's why I'm bringing it up here today. I want action arising out of today, because the story has changed over the last 8 to 9 days. The Senator Thomas Byrne was told last week that the discussions had ended with the drug company, and we got a bit of drug company bashing. We don't need any of that. We need hard-nosed, sleeves rolled up, get involved in this and make sure that these people can have access to this drug therapy, which can transform their lives. And, I mean, you're talking about lifespan being equal to any normal situation once they're on the drug therapy.
Thank you, Deputy. I'll call Taoiseach.
Well, I'd like to think that we could live in a country whereby these situations wouldn't have to arise in the first place. I'd like to think that people who suffer from life-threatening ailments, be they cancer or be they heart conditions or whatever else, could have treatment and drug treatment and medical attention brought to their lives much quicker. Now, in response to Deputy McEntee's question yesterday evening, the Minister pointed out that as the Dáil is well aware, that the Health Service Executive has a statutory responsibility for decisions on pricing and on reimbursement of medical products under the Community Drugs Scheme that's there. Now, this drug, as you're well aware, is for the treatment of people like Mr. Duggan with PNH. It is considered to be one of the most expensive drugs in the world. Alexion Pharma are the drugs company involved. They've been engaged now for some time in trying to arrive at a price that would assist in its desire to fund this medicine for people who need it. The HSE have been very adamant about that. This is a company that are not that easy to deal with. And what we'd like to think is that within the resources available, that this measure could be accommodated. And that's why, given the responsibility that they have for drug pricing and for reimbursement, that they engage properly with the company producing the drug. My understanding, Deputy Martin, is that the price being offered at the moment would involve the medicine in question costing €420,000 per annum for each additional patient that's treated. as I say, one of the most expensive drugs in the world. You can't put a price, obviously, on a life. You cannot put a price on a life, but it is it's responsible position for the health service executive and the department in engaging with Alexei and Pharma to get the best deal possible for both for the taxpayers, but more fundamentally for the patients who need these who need this kind of treatment. The discussions between Alexia and Pharma and the HSE have concluded, and the health service executive is now considering the outcome of that, of those discussions and of that engagement. It's regrettable that the company have not been able to provide this drug at a more sustainable price to the health service executive to reflect the clinical evidence that we know exists. I would have thought that for a company like this, in the interests of understanding that we have a pilot program for 10 people, given pilot program.
Sorry, the Taoiseach to conclude, please.
It's about 10 lives as well, Deputy Martin, and I can't discriminate or make a decision between the important. I can't make a decision between one life and another. As you said, I'm not acting here. I don't have. Deputy Martin.
Sorry. We have to conclude on this.
If you want to make political points about a matter that's of life and death, as you say, then continue to do it. Position here is that the health service executive quite rightly have engaged with Alexion Pharma, the company who produced this drug. It is a drug that has given great comfort, ease and extension of life to people. It is costing 420,000 extra per annum per patient. The health service executive are right to engage with the drugs company because they are the body that have to deal with drug pricing and drug reimbursement.
Thank you.
Now they've concluded those negotiations, and I would say in view of the fact that this was raised by Deputy McEntee, that Alexia and Pharma should listen to the points that have been made here, and perhaps they might arrive at a more acceptable price regime, so that this medicine could be available not just to the two people that you mentioned, not just to the 10 people who are on the pilot program, but to others who are in this particular category as well.
Thank you.
And I hope that Alexia and Pharma listen to the voice that raised here last evening and today from the
Thank
Parliament.
Thank you. Now call Deputy Gerry Adams. Could we have order, please?